So what would you advise for someone who is struggling with perhaps having sex or even just exploring their sexuality during cancer or just after their cancer treatment?
Look, I guess I would advise them that this is a really hard time of life for anyone. And so to be kind on themselves in that process, because sexuality is one of the great mysteries of life, and no one cracks the code entirely. It's always a confusing thing. You're becoming an individual. You're becoming someone with your own wants and desires and needs. And because you're going through cancer, it doesn't mean that those needs are any less important. They might receive less of your attention. They might receive less of your focus. But when we talk to young people about this stuff, sometimes that itself can be a really hard decision to make, to focus on treatment to the exclusion of all of the things they perceive to be the normal adolescence they're missing out on. You know, I hate the word normal, but that's something that really comes along for young people to say, oh, it's not fair that I don't get a chance to have boyfriends or girlfriends, you know, because I'm so focused on treatment. It doesn't mean that intimacy is less important to you. It also doesn't mean that you have to forego all of the sexual intimacy that your peers are having. It just means that negotiating things may be part of the early conversation in a way your peers don't have to deal with.